I think, when people turn up to restaurants now, they do want to know where the food's come from. I mean, it's definitely changed from sort of when I started cooking. I don't think people were as interested. They just wanted something on a plate that was tasty. But in a restaurant now, it's all about the sort of experience as well as just the meal. People want to ask about the dishes. They want to know where you pick that from, or, you know, why you've chose that piece instead of that piece. You know, the story behind food, and, you know, food miles is a massive thing. Beginning of my career was like a lot of chefs start out. I was a 14-year-old boy that didn't know what he wanted to do, really. I was washing up part-time. I suppose I just fell in love with the whole kitchen atmosphere, and yeah, just absolutely loved it. So as soon as I finished my GCSEs, got on my moped and drove straight to a full-time job. Spent about 3 months travelling around Asia. Then I went over into Australia. Worked in some great restaurants in Australia, and then really took the time to sort of see all the different sort of food styles that were going on. I think, you know, by the time I'd come back to England after Australia, I think I had my own sort of vision on food and what food should be from all the incredible places that I'd worked. What I took from travelling was, looking at different countries, and they've all got these sort of dishes that date back hundreds of years with recipes passed down from families to families. What I didn't come back to England with what a lot of chefs do was, you know, I'm going to start using soy sauce and chilies and all this to, you know, work with local produce. Like, I've got nothing against that, but sort of I came back to England and thought, you know, all these countries have got fantastic heritage in the food, but whereas in England, everything's just so mixed match. So what I really wanted to do was just start looking back at history and what we used to do, basically, and, you know, sort of build dishes that way. Things like, you know, foraging that we do, it's not because it's, you know, a fad or a trend. It's just something that's been around for hundreds of years, and, you know, it's something that we've stopped doing. You know, hogweed seeds, you know, give us flavours like orange and cardamom to put into the dishes, or things like licorice, which we can get from down in Yorkshire. It's, it might not be a sort of fully native British thing, but that licorice has got a big reason to be in Yorkshire. It's something that was brought over like many, many years ago. You know, it's something that grows again, that will quite happily grow in our soil. I've used the sweetbreads and the belly for this dish. So with the sweetbreads, I've just lightly blanched them and then peeled them down. They've just been blanched in a sort of court bouillon, so quite an old school way. Just onions, garlic, bay leaf, a couple of bits of a few fresh herbs, basically thyme, parsley. Just lightly blanched them in that, peeled them down, and they're just going to be coated in sort of ash breadcrumbs. They'll look sort of really black. And then, I'm going to deep fry them. They're going to go with a lamb belly. So the belly's been, again, brined for 2 days, and then we've confit that in its own fat. So basically all the trimmings off a lamb, we render all that down, and then we cook it back in its own fat again. Just because lamb fat's got such a great flavour. I think it's probably one of the best flavours of when it comes to the different animal fats. That's the sort of two lamb elements on the dish. That's finished with a little cauliflower yogurt. It's just infused with a little bit of a truffle, a rye crumb on there. And then it's just finished with black garlic, which again we make ourselves, and a couple of sort of fresh shoots. The sweetbread, I suppose, is the actual star of the show on this. I think, with fried sweetbreads, it's I like them a couple of different ways, sweetbreads, but fried, when it's got a nice sort of crispy outside in it, almost reminds me of like a chicken nugget, if you will. It's a big chef favourite, is sweetbreads, but for the general public, I think they all seem a bit scared when they sort of, you know, see a sweetbread on the menu. They're a bit cautious of it, but I don't think there should be any reason why. I suppose with this one, it's all just about preparation. Again, fine produce and preparation. Everything takes a bit of time, as always with my cooking. I've got incredible suppliers just all around on my doorstep. We've got incredible wild produce and vegetables, cheese suppliers, everything. I really want to sort of bring those native British ingredients back to life. And that's the way I find my different flavours. It's not by, you know, importing something from Japan, or, you know, taking something from Spain, although, you know, they might be fantastic produce. It sort of makes no sense to be taking that and then pairing it with, you know, a local protein or a local vegetable. It needs to be, the whole thing needs to be native British.